What's going on there, kids? It's your boy Dave. Another video? Oh shit, man, you know, I don't know what the fuck I'm doing. Hopefully y'all won't see that. Y'all probably won't. I won't edit it all because I don't give a fuck. It is what it is. Anyway, this is a segment of Talk About It, where I talk about whatever it is I want to talk about. Actually, I want to talk about a TV show I watched on while I braid my hair, if y'all don't mind. Y'all mind? Cool. While I watched on MTV, and the name of the show was called, World's Strictest Parents on MTV. As everyone knows, I work more towards like the night, so I like to get up and go to the gym, excuse me, and work out another good place. I happened to be flipping through the channels, eating my breakfast, mind you. I went to the damn gym. You would think I would have like a little simple little bran muffin and maybe a piece of fruit. Not my fellas. I came home, I had a piece of bacon like a muffin. Bacon, had some eggs, and some damn toast. Anyway, so I happened to be flipping through the channels and so forth and so on, and the show came on, and I was just like, the world's strictest parents, like, what the hell was that about? Basically, the show was mainly about kids that are extremely bad towards their parents. Like, they drink, they smoke, they do whatever bad kids actually do, whatever. They curse, they do everything that, please, no jokes. but they talk. And they're some ruthless kids, and they move in for a week with these strictest parents, and it just amazes me how like some kids are just like really, really fucking crazy. Like kids like really, really got some issues. And what bothered me about the show a little bit is that they mainly talk about the kids, but what the fuck about the parents? Because obviously the parents got some damn issues that they can't be controlling they damn kid. Talk about it. I mean, because when I was growing up, I had some problems with my mother, and the main reason is because me and my mother are extremely alike, but people didn't know everything that my mother used to say to me, or do to me, or nothing. They just automatically thought, oh, well, it's the kid's fault, and that's not always the case. Not to say that kids are innocent, because by far, no kid is fucking innocent, trust me. It could more than likely it could be the parents too, and a lot of people don't realize that shit. Like they just instantly think, well, it's the kid's fault or blah 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 and so forth and so on. When in all actuality, it's really, really not. I mean, in most cases, it could possibly be the fucking parent just being like an Indian, just not really paying attention, not really trying to know their child. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, like, the show was extremely, extremely funny. Like, it was one where this black woman and her husband was white, and she was just, like, a straight Southern woman. Very much just like, no, bitch, you're not going to be doing that, so I don't know what the fuck you're about to do, but they want to fix that. And these two kids came in, whatever, two white kids. One of them was, like, this punk rocker dude. He had, like, these piercings and shit, whatever, and all that type of other shit. And the other chick was, like, this, like, white girl that looks extremely innocent. Well, this bitch was crazy. Cursing and smoking cigarettes and doing all types of shit. Which, first of all, and these kids, like, their parents knew that they smoked cigarettes. My mother would have fucking punched my throat and cave my chest in. I would have been like this, walking. Confused, that shit. And my mother, mind you, I started smoking when I was 22, but I was a full adult. If you're 16, there's no reason why you should be fucking smoking no damn cigarettes. Like, I don't agree with that at all. So they went there to go move in, whatever, for a weekend. The dude was okay. He was kind of crazy, but he wasn't too bad. Like, but the little white girl was on like some G shit. Like, because like the black mother was just like, yeah, can you like you need to go wash the dishes or the blinds there. And she said, well, I'm doing your chores, so you need to like leave me alone. I thought this black woman was about to go to jail. Yeah, I thought she was really about to go to jail for, like, really busting the shit out of, like, someone else's kid. Because she was about to ride the shit. Now, you could tell that she was just like, okay, I got cameras right there. But, bitch, if these cameras wasn't there, your ass would have been on the floor, not even breathing. drool on that shit, gone. But, and then, like, they show, and then they show, like, towards, like, the end of the week, whatever, the kids get, like, a letter from, their parents, whatever, and the kids start crying and shit. Well, I'm like, I'm gonna change. And then, at the end of the week, like, the parents come to pick up the kids, and the other parents that took care of their kids for a week tell them, like, look, this is exactly what your child was, and so forth and so on, and blase, blase, like, either your child was disrespectful or, they basically tell them the whole week, like, okay, like, your child came in, it was horrible, da-da-da-da, but they've grown better, and this is what I think you need to do in order to get that. The moral of the whole show really is, like, kids need discipline, no matter how old you are. I don't care what no one said, like, your parent is your parent. Granted, my mother's fucking nuts, but I still respected her growing up, because, like, I was in her house, and she's my mother. Like, there's no smoking cigarettes in her house. Mind you, I'm 24, and I'm about to be 25 in that 1 month. But I would never, like, I still can't go to her house and smoke. You know what I'm saying? It's a matter of respect and decency. It's like, what the fuck are you doing? Like, so, like, these kids is crazy, and these parents is fucking crazy. Cause I watched damn well, if my kid, 16, Thomas Amiyama, what the fuck was I talking about? Let's talk about it. Yeah, Dad, I'm about to go smoke a cigarette. Oh, really? All right, cool. Go ahead. You about to go smoke a cigarette? I'm about to go whoop some ass. That's what I'm about to do. You about to get your ass busted open, your head split, your lips gone. Gone, that shit. Won't know why now. I swear. But anyway, the show is extremely well, but just because of the MTV, especially MTV and especially VH1, they do any damn thing to get a damn rating. Just the devil, I tell you. But anyway, as you want to see, I did my braids. This is from my previous video. So, I did my braids. I'm about to go in the dryer for, like, a little bit, whatever. Yeah, I got some shit kind of, like, sticking up. Shut up. Don't say nothing about it. Please do not hang me, because I ain't the one. But anyway, so, yeah, that was really it. That's what my main emphasis on the video was. Sorry, y'all. Was to talk about that. And just at the end of the day, parents, seriously, really, I know I don't have kids well, but take care of your damn kids. Discipline them, because they need that. They need that structure, and it will eventually help. Now, mind you, granted, my mother, is like what I said earlier, was a little bit crazy, and we act exactly alike, so that's why we had so many problems, but she instilled so many great things in me, because she disciplined me, she got me in, she got me together, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, that's basically it. Also, I don't know if I showed you my second tattoo, someone had asked about it, but that's it. It means happiness, the Chinese symbol. I got the breast cancer one too, earlier, a couple of months ago. But anyway, this is your boy Dave, just signing in, doing another video. And as always, stay blessed, and I love y'all, and to all my new subscribers and old subscribers, I thank y'all so much. Alright, and I'll talk to y'all soon. Alright, bye. I remember when you used to be mine, way back when, I was too naive to love you. But now, if I only had the opportunity, I would do anything, because my